everyone, and welcome back to Farming Simulator 15 Gold Edition. My name is Bluestar, and I'm just trying to pick up, right at where we ended the last video. We just got that great demand for sugar beet. Got it all sold in. As you can see, we've got a little over $372,000 up there in the upper right corner. Getting some of the equipment back here. I'm finishing map here. I've got the combine still out there on that field number 8 there, trying to finish the canola off of it. We still got field 7 and 13 to finish harvesting. Got the great big T8 out there with the cultivator on field number 9, getting it ready. So that's where we're at. We're currently picking up. I'm returning this guy back over here to the BGA biogas plant. Still trying to decide, what we got to invest our money in here. Extra $300,000 we currently have. Grass fields are fully grown again, so we can harvest that again. Can we beat the car? Can we beat the car? Can we beat him? Can we beat him? Yeah, we should beat him. Got to work that we can get a little extra money here. Let's see here, it's gonna be that. Which route is it? Beat? No, BGA. That's right. We had erased the routes because we were redoing them. Yay! I almost totally forgot about that. So, let's first of all get our bucket back in shape here then. I guess we'll go ahead and set this course route back up. Okay, it's about right, but we'll lift it up because we don't want to scoop up none quite yet. So we'll go ahead and get this route recreated here. Let's see here. We are doing a unload route. So get our tractor line up here the best we can. About the center. About. And we'll start just a little bit back there. Start recording. Go forward. I hope I remember all these markers correctly. Actually, I think I already messed up. Let's destroy that. I think I already had messed up. Let's see. Yep. Okay. Right about there. We still centered? Yes, we are. Okay. This is the hardest of all of them to set up, so I'm kind of trying to remember it in detail. Okay, let's see. Start recording. I'm going to pull forward a little bit. About right there. Set a waypoint. Now I'm going to go forward. gotta put all these little temporary waypoints every time we want a bucket change. I don't want to go backwards on the tractor. Try not to overspeed going backwards. Unfortunately, there's not a cruise control setting for backwards. Straight back. And just before we hit, that's where we're going to stop. Go forward. Okay. Come over here. Right down the lane. I'll line this up the best I can. There, put another waypoint. Reverse out. As you can see, coming in, I got a little off center. It's fine, won't hurt nothing. Start turning the tractor. Forward. Okay, bucket positions. We'll see if they're still detecting. We'll go ahead and test it real quick. Well, seems to work so far. Wow, look at the speed. Doing 20. Well, looks like I didn't do too bad. Remember how to set up this course. Bumping the wall. That kind of does bother me a little. Let's slow the street speed down just a hair. No, it's working. So, save VGA unload 1. it's working, so leave it alone. Okay, you're done. Pull back up. And there's no reason to fold you up. Gotta do field number 8 next. What I do need to do. Okay, you're done, so stop driver. Clear course, switch you to. Build 13. S7, build 713, grain unload. Wheel to corn. Don't tell you nearest. Okay, drive now. Oops. Okay, stop, you stop, stop, stop. Gotta get the rest of the grain first. All the way around twice. Okay. Off with canola. $1,400 there. Offloading the biogas plant, BGA, or however they refer to it now. Yeah, they call it biogas. I did get a little bit of a news. Last month, at I believe they call it E3. I'm not exactly 100% sure what it talks about. But Giants was talking about the release of Farming Simulator 17. So if for those of you who've been keeping up with the different years, you know they came out with 2009, then 11, then 13, and here we are on 15 right now. So 17 it has been announced. I did not see an actual release date. I am kind of expecting the October time frame, like they have been in the past. You know, there's no guarantees in that. But it has been announced. It's not, you know, overly surprising to me. Where is... It's back at the farm. Wow. Really? My corn head is all the way at the main farm. Okay. I'll be right back, guys. Gonna obviously go get the head and bring it back across. See you in a few. Hey guys, and welcome back. As you can see, I went ahead and went across the farm and got my corn head on the front of my combine here. Got him harvesting here. Got the route set up, get everything going again. Sorry about that. I don't even remember how I ended up putting the corn head all the way over there back there at the main farm. Instead of leaving it out here near these fields where I normally use it. We got it. We got it fixed. We got it going. Continuing getting these last two fields here harvested. As you can see, it's going to be a lot of corn. Which should bring our corn stock levels kind of up near that, near everybody else there. Kind of looking now that the canola's been turned in. It's slightly a little bit still behind the wheat and the barley, but that's fine. Nothing major there. Go ahead and get that done. Been trying to, you know, think a little bit while I was off screen, getting this reset back up, you know, what I want to spend our money on that we have here, this $300,000. We can actually, we had a little bit of options. One, we could actually trade in the combine. We're looking at it right here, right now. That way we can get the slightly larger one. You know, with that, we have to replace the heads. You know, the corn and the grain head that's on the front of it. We could do that. We could actually get the little smaller version of this that we've never used yet out. We could probably look at buying, well, actually, with the trade-in, we might be able to get one of the New Hollands. Let's look at it right here real quick. Combines. As you can see, we can go all the way across here to the right. This is the small version I was telling you about. The little, ooh, it's 20% discount right now. This is the one we should be running. As you can see, it says we own one. It's currently one we're running. You know, it's cost us, you know, quite a bit a day. This one's slightly more. A little bit bigger, more horsepower. Definitely designed to handle the PS900 series versus the PS700 series. And then this little bitty one that is available is suitable for the 600R. So we can go over here and look at the different heads real quick. There they are. There's the 700 we have. Big one can handle the 900. And then we go across over here. Suitable for the RSM 1403, is that what it was called? Yes, RMS 1403. Suitable for the 600R. See, so many different names, you gotta make sure you line these up before you buy. 600R, there it is. Ooh, we'll handle that for the corn. RMS 1403. This will work on the 1403. This will work on the 1403. So there's the grain head for the 1403 right there. We can get the little bitty guy out. You know, he'll speed us up a little bit, because then we'll have two harvesters versus just the one. So we can look at doing that. We can save our, can you save money and try to get one of these other harvesters here? That's actually the small New Holland. Where's the big New Holland? There he is. We quite don't have the money for the big New Holland here. Barely can do the chase, but then we have to be able to get the head. That's why we have to be able to sell in our other harvester to do those. But the other thing I was looking at is leave things the way we got right here right now. And if we go back to our forestry system, scroll across here, we can actually afford the Scorpion right now to cut down our trees instead of having to use our chainsaw. We still have to be able to come up with our tractor to go hook to our the logging guy here. But we should be able to, you know, cut with a Scorpion, set a pre-measurement length and cut. So I know we hadn't done logging a lot, so that's where I think I want to go. Ta-da! That went all of our money. Is this, we pretty much have a course play route. It's pretty sustainable. It's, I mean, it is stable. It runs on its own. You know, a few little minor adjustments here and there. And this guy, really, we don't want to seed until the fields are ready to seed, so. Let's run over here real quick. I don't see our Scorpion. Ah, that's right. The new purchase of vehicles inside. We might be able to see through the window. I think I kind of see him through the window bay there. See him in the window, guys? I'm not sure how good the video quality is going to be on YouTube when this is done and finally finish up loading, but kind of see him right there in the bay. Okay. Let's hitch this guy up. First of all, I'll get that off my screen. Okay, we've got him hooked up. There he is. Jump out and take a look at it. Our great brand new Scorpion here. Any of you that's ever seen Farming Simulator 15, this guy is not new. He's been around for a little while. But he's got the great big tree cutter right here on the top. You can see that great big blade right there. Doesn't look kind of sharp. But he'll snap a tree down. Those upper wheels there will grab him. This guy is a little bit weird to drive because he does have that, you know, center turn point. Let's see. I'm trying to look at my commands. I'm turning the upper left corner real quick. Turn on the harvester. Actually, let's come around the front side that we can see that. That's off. That's on. Okay, change cutting length. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll try 5. Because we have, what, 1 through 8? So we have 1 through 8. We'll start at 5. See how it fits on our trailer. Next, just, you know, find a tree here. That thing moves around a lot up front, doesn't it? Got the tree. Get it down as low as possible, and there goes the old tree tipping over. One good thing about this guy is you can drag him out a little bit here. Lift it up, turn him over here to the side. I can work the controls right. Okay. Okay. The one log goes rolling down the hill here. Oops. I'd like to stop, that'd be nice, thank you. Lines up. This is the 5 meter? Is that what they were measuring as meters? Actually, 5 meters looks just about right, doesn't it? Cool. is probably not the best, trying to grab, you know, multiple ones at one time. Yeah, it's what I thought. If we can get this pulled around here and put in here anyway. Still not the best at doing this part, but we'll do what we can. Okay, lift it up. There we go. Oops, did I get it? I don't think I did. Okay, getting the controls backwards here. Last piece. So I'm trying to think of what else has been going on. Oh, a few of us gotten together. We're trying something out. It's a game called 7 Days to Die. You've probably heard of it in the past. I've never been a huge major fan of it, mainly because it's hard. It's very, very hard. It's still in alpha testing, so you can play it a little bit. They'll change something, they'll modify it, and then you'll lose your game or have to restart your game over. So I've never been, you know, a lot into that game, but we fired up a server, and when I say we, I'm talking about, you know, Brad in M73, myself, Savvy, who I've played with, Blovey's been on a little bit, that he's spotlighted in, you know, a video of two of me and Savvy's Minecraft series that we did back with Regrowth. That's going. Let's see. Okay, he's still working. Just checking on those guys real quick. So, yeah, we're playing around, trying to see what it's like to play, you know, multiplayer on the on the server. Turn on Harvester. Trying to talk and drive and cut trees here at the same time. Hello. Wrap around it or not. Did it miss? There we go. Lift it up, turn it to the side here. Try something new here. It may not work. This may be reckless, but we can try. Okay, let's try this. Let's pull the tree this way a little bit. don't have the ability to turn it. What I was gonna hopefully trying to do is, you know how it cuts, see if I can possibly go up the hill. Drag the tree up the hill. Now. Turn it the other way. Turn this way. See if we can flip it around here. Where's it at? Okay, turn it. Take it to my left. Lower it down a little bit. Over here to my left. Okay. Now. Back her up like this. Nope. This might be foolish, but I'm gonna try it anyway. Trees kind of looks like it's starting to be lined up a little bit. Bring it down. If I can do this, bring it in. Lift it up. Okay. Back down the hill, back down the hill. Stop, 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 stop. A little too far. Let's try it. Aha! Kinda work. Turn it just a little bit more like that. Oh, bring it back up. That way it can go on the treadle more. Did it work? Did it kinda work? Cheek a little bit here. Definitely not proper usage of this equipment. Let me push it on. Push, 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 push. Haha. Like I said, not my proper use of the equipment, but no one ever said you had to do it exactly right. Okay, let's go get this tree. Okay. Over to the left here again. Front of us a little bit until we get further down here. I'm making a mess now. Yeah, now I'm making a mess. That's ugly. That's definitely ugly. That one's on the ground. Yep, some of you get just gonna have to fall off. That one's gonna come off, that one's gonna fall off. Maybe just too many trees. Definitely didn't help, I didn't have the right angle. Alright, we're gonna lose some of them. Might as well find it out. Yep, lost that one. Those are falling. We'll have to come back and pick them up. Bet you, as you saw from that first one I tried, you know, if you had a good angle, it would work pretty decent. I probably should have, you know, repositioned after I saw how that first log fell, fixed it, and, you know, repositioned somehow. Pull it out, yeah. Pull out. There we go. Okay. Now let's go back and see how many more of these we gotta pick up. We got our hook hanging off the side of the trailer. That wouldn't be normal. Stuff's falling on my desk here. There we go. Come on. Not the best. pushed on?
Yep, yeah, pushed him.
Got him pushed on this time. So. Go get his tree here. Zoom way out. That's the best we can zoom out. Yeah, see, that's part of the problem right there is the angle. We're already coming down to it. So, oh man. Totally forgot about that. You cannot get out of Scorpion at all, or he will drop the tree just like he just did on me. Okay, so we're back to doing this one the old-fashioned way. See that little line down there? Okay. Ah, you're done. Cool. Let's see here. Hit the wrong button. We're gonna do wrap around, we're gonna do that direction. Actually, no. It'll normal, we'll just take it off. It should have plenty of room on the ends to do his turnarounds. Continue backing up a little bit here. Come on, lift it. Obviously this one's cut looks like longer than 5 meters here. Alright, just a little bit, flip on, flip on, flip on. Yeah, you're definitely longer than 5 meters. Okay. Can you back it up here? These others picked up here. Yeah, it works. Not the best, but lift it up here. Of course, like I said, let's just throw it right back down on the ground because we can't work the controls. Two more up there. More on here, move it down. Okay, we got one more up there if we can get it. Okay. Hopefully we all have it here. Nice and slow, nice and slow. Just notice there in the upper right corner, we're up to 130,000. Like we're up to, let's see, we were at 130, now we're 150, so roughly $20,000 for that load of logs. I don't know if, did we have someone unload while we were doing that? We didn't have no way to unload and make money, so. Check on everybody, make sure everybody's still working okay. Looks like it. Get the last fill here harvested. Yep, there he is. He finished cultivating. Cool. Now that we have the scorpion, I might come over here and clear some of these trees out right here, just to make it a little bit easier to get between fields. So all of those right there along that side there are the brick tree for the scorpion to handle. Going well. All right, guys. I'm gonna pause the video here, probably end the episode because the length of it, and come back and we'll continue working and learning how to work with a scorpion here. So thanks for watching as always. Please don't forget to hit the like, share, and subscribe buttons, guys. I do appreciate it, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.